Amen.
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 If you don't say amen, I'll suspect you. Amen.
Amen.
When you go to some assemblies, they treat the Last Supper Day like a funeral service. Yeah. You put things monyoro like somebody is dead.
Yeah.
No. Our Jesus is not dead.
Amen. What?
Amen.
Amen.
Sister in blue, please can you put your phone down? Thank you. And can you help me, please? Come, I have an assignment for you. The lady in blue. The lady in blue. This last exercise that I have some fruits in them. I want you to take the fruits over there to the arbiter and then cut them in two equal halves and then bring them back to me, please. Amen.
Amen.
So then how long do I have?
Second.
12:20. Up to 12:20.
No, it's not 12:20.
It's not 12:20.
We close one.
So we have 40 minutes.
Yeah.
Okay. Amen.
Amen.
Is that your telephone? Is that your telephone?
Mm-hmm.
My gift card. Can I see it? It's a Samsung, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Is your Bible on it?
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you. I received a video last time on our platform. A lady that God revealed unto her that we should not come to church with our Bibles on our phones and tablets and stuff. I don't know if some of you have received it. I have the video here. If not because of time, I'll pray for you to hear the revelation that God revealed unto her. And I'm always with my Bibles. I have about 6 different Bibles here. But when I listen to that prophecy or that revelation, I mainly bought a new Bible. Yes. For sometimes, like now, you pick up your phone. Everybody think you are reading your Bible. Meanwhile, you are reading what?
What's up?
Messages.
Not only that, you might not solicit for dirty pictures, but a friend who wants to concern you will send you a picture. Whilst you are busy with your Bible, bam, the message comes. You press on it and you see, what kind of dirty thing is that? Let me ask you the question. Can you eat from a plate where you have spat at the side of the plate?
No.
Your own spit on the side of the plate and you eat another half.
No.
Can you do that?
No.
If we can't do that, then we shouldn't put our Bibles on our phones. Because our Bibles contain certain things that are despicable that we have to even not talk about today. Mm-hmm. So I will entreat each one of you to get paper Bible. I have 6 different types here. I don't use them. Today I'm going to use the one on paper.
Amen.
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 The Holy Spirit is here. Amen. He has already moved through here.
Amen.
So I have nothing more on my own than the letter that He has given unto me to share with you. Amen.
Amen.
Normally, when I stand, I don't preach. I like teachings. If I teach, it helps, most especially our left eye like this, our age like that. Amen.
Amen.
Me, if you see me, don't think I'm that old. When they come to dance, I'll dance. I'm not the kind of elders who do when I see they're going to die tomorrow. Me, I'm dynamic. I'm energetic. When they come to dance, I will dance. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. I saw the dance, brother. God bless you. You are full of something.
Yes.
Amen. There's power inside of you. Everybody of you here has something unique. Every one of you has something unique. So the teaching I'm going to teach you, I've entitled is Potentials. Potentials. I'm going to begin by asking a question. Which part of this earth is the richest part? The richest part of this earth. Is it the gold mines of Obuasi? The richest. US. Good. He says US. Okay. Somebody else.
The richest part of this earth.
On this planet Earth, the richest. That has.
Is
it a country or a place? It's a place.
I know.
Somebody said Dubai.
Dubai has the answer.
You have the answer. Yes, I heard him saying it. But he dares not. Sister, what's the richest part of this planet? The richest. Cemetery. Let's pray for her. If you are not sure, say it. If I was supposed to reward 100 euro, I should got it. But I had to say, Now, why is the cemetery the richest part of this planet? Why?
Because it is filled with like many talents, like people who were dead. Let's say, for instance, like Michael Jackson and those people who came on this earth, like to do something like with their talent, they're all dead and gone. And like in the grave, that's where you find the richest people that are there.
Amen.
I can add one or two things to my
add to it.
Some people for the poor. They didn't get the chance to accomplish it, so they are all under the grave.
They didn't have the chance to accomplish it. Okay, God bless you. You are all right. The cemetery or the graveyard is the richest part of this planet. It's not the gold mines, no. It's not the oil fields, no. It's a cemetery. Most of us here are writers of books. Most of you here, especially you have a powerful voice. I heard you singing. It's something God has invested in you. Amen. Somebody's own can be a poem writing. Somebody's own can be a rhymes writing. You know rhymes?
Yeah.
Somebody's own can be painting, pictures. Somebody's own can be designing. You rush to Zara, you rush to H&M, you rush to the mayor to buy expensive things. You think they just came from anywhere to hang there? Somebody sat down and used pencil to draw it. And whilst he can draw it, somebody can make it. And if somebody can make it and you can buy it, then why don't you design it yourself? These things we call them potentials. It's very sad that our youth nowadays, they are into certain things that I can't even understand or I can't describe. What you have, you don't respect it. What you have, you don't respect it. Most people will be chasing the trams and the trains to go to their work places. Sometimes they work in a vehicle, in a shop. They want to be there on time, otherwise their boss will be angry. Meanwhile, they were supposed to be the boss of that shoe shop. So when they receive 1,500 euro, they are very, very happy. They are smiling, oh, their money is in account. You are supposed to be the manager or the owner of that company. Why are all these things hidden inside of us? Why? I'm going to give you the secret. If you want to explore what is inside of you, then you must go to the one who put it there. You understand me? Take our Bibles and let's go to some place. Genesis chapter 1, verses 11 and 12. Genesis chapter 1. Where is the lady bringing my fruit? There's a knife in the sack. I brought everything. There's a knife in the sack already. Who is there? Genesis.
One.
I don't want you to read from the mobile phone. Brother, please, can you help me? Genesis chapter 1, verse 11 and 12.
I'm reading from Genesis chapter 1, verse 11. Then God said.
Then God, who is speaking here?
God.
Who is speaking?
God.
Okay.
Let the earth bring forth grass. The herb that yields seed, and the fruit tree that yields fruit according to its kind, whose seed is in itself, on the earth and it was so. And the earth brought forth grass, the herb that yields seed according to its kind, and the tree that yields fruit, whose seed is in itself according to its kind. And God saw that it was good. So the evening and the morning were the third day.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you. We are all talking about potentials. Let me define it for you before the fruit comes. Potential is what you can do, but you have not done yet. Potential is where you can reach, but you have not reached yet. Potential is what you can accomplish, but you have not accomplished yet. That means what's inside of you must have time to come out. Okay? I repeat. Potential is an untapped strength. All of you have power in you. But if you don't use the power, it is hidden and it's dormant. I missed one thing. My Nkati, where is Nkati? Open Nkati for me, thank you. What is Nkati in Netherlands?
What?
Amen. Potential is unused to success. Last time when we came there, there was a brother who was going for his report. Where is he? The one who passed?
Manfred.
Where is Manfred?
He's playing football today.
Oh, okay. Manfred received his report. He was very happy. But let me tell you one secret. The only enemy to your potential is not the witch, it's not Satan, but it's your last accomplished success. I repeat, if you have a potential within you, nobody can take it away except one thing, the success that you last achieved. For example, Mansfield received his report, he has passed, he got A+. Right? Manfred said, whoa, I'm happy. I'm not grateful that I have achieved A+. And Manfred will sleep the whole day. Do you think Manfred will progress further? No, he will drop. So your last success, if you don't take care, it will bring you backwards. And any time you achieve a success and you don't die, that means God wants you to go further. Are we here? Okay. So Genesis, where our father read, the Bible says, then God said, let the earth bring forth grass, the herb that yields seed, say seed.
Seed.
Seed. And the fruit tree that yields fruit according to its kind, whose seed is in itself. Whose seed is in itself. Amen.
Amen.
Mm-hmm. Look here, something is coming on the earth, and it was so. Verse 12. And the earth brought forth grass, the herb that yields seed according to its kind. That means the earth obeyed what God said. Okay, let's continue. And the tree that yields fruit, whose seed was in itself, the fruit brought the seed that is in itself. Begin to understand here? Okay, let's see what God said again. According to its kind. That means the apple tree can never bear the pear tree. The pear tree can never bear the noting tree. Everything moves according to its own kind. You understand? Let's move on. And what did God do? And God saw it, and it was what? It was
good.
That's how you are. I brought this fruit for you to see that. God made something inside of you like a seed. The seed is hidden inside of it. So I had to cut it open before I can display the seed. But can I cut it open?
No.
No. If I cut it open, what will happen?
Die.
Police will come after me. I don't have to go that far. But the moment you can understand this principle, it's much easier. But let me ask you one question. If I hold this pear seed in my hand, and I ask you, what's your name? Prince. Prince, what do I have in my hand? Seed of what?
Pear.
Thank you.
Papaya.
Brother, what do I have in my hand?
Seed.
Thank you.
Seed of pear.
My dear, what do I have in my hand?
Seed.
You are all wrong.
it's a pear.
A fruit. It's a pear, it's a seed, it's a pear. Let me show you this. There's a difference between, I'm teaching here, hold on. There's a difference between a fact and a truth. The truth is, you are right, I'm holding a pear seed in my hand. But the truth is, I'm having a forest of pear. Why am I having a forest of it? Forest is plenty, plenty, you can't even
count.
Why is that so? Let me put the microphone down because you can't hear me, yeah? Mm-hmm. Let me put this one here. Let me take it. This pear contains the seed. The seed I put in the ground, it will germinate, another seed will come, mm-hmm. best about 500 of these, yeah. Inside of it is another seed. I will plant it will come out, another one again, inside. Another seed, inside of it, I will plant it, another, by the time I realize, the whole tenant is filled with what?
Pear.
So here we are, we just look at our facts. Then we forget that there is a truth inside of us. You particular, I don't know why you are singing, something push me.
Yeah.
You have not just a mere seed, you have a forest inside of you.
Amen.
Amen.
You need to bring something out.
Amen.
If I don't cut this pear, I wouldn't know it contains only one single seed. But when I get the boldness to take the seed out of it and put it in the right soil, with the right condition, a time will come, I will not have one single pair, but I'll have 500 of them. So if presiding says we need praise and worship team, you have a tone like this, it's a small seed. Oh yes. When you come here, you will develop it, and by the time you realize you have your own album of seeding.
Amen.
It can happen.
Amen.
Because those people who produces their albums, they are no more than you. They don't have sense less.
Mm-hmm.
I've been MC for people who launching their books and CDs, and you sing better than them, I tell you. So make sense out of it. So your potential is like the seed. If this seed is left on this carpet, do you think it will grow? Do you think I speak tongues? Hey, germinate right now. Jesus, do you think it will obey me?
No.
It needs the right environment. It needs the right place to be. It needs the right care. Most of you are like that. The company that you mingle with, the friends you move along with, the classmates you play and talk to, they are the poor environment. They will never let your seed grow. If I want this seed to multiply, God said, after creating everything, he said, be fruitful and what?
Multiply.
He did not say, be seedful. Check the Bible.
Yeah.
He didn't say, be seedful. Be fruitful. Why? Because inside the fruit is the seed. Inside another fruit is the seed. Inside another fruit is the seed. By the time you realize, you have a forest.
Yes.
So, ladies and gentlemen, it's a high time you distinguish your facts and your truth. The fact is, of course, I'm seeing an apple seed. But by the time I take the seed from one single fruit into the right environment, I'll have multiples of them. These are the potentials you have within you. But it is Yama that we are going to see the idol. That something will happen suddenly, yes, oh, that young man, obituary, gone too soon. He's gone too soon with all the seed inside of him buried. You were supposed to write songs, you didn't write them, it's gone. You're supposed to write poems, it's gone. You're supposed to write books for children's play at school, it's gone. You can do it. If God says, be fruitful, it means he has put a seed inside of
you.
In economics, we call something demand and supply. God will never demand what he has never supplied. Never.
It's true.
He has put something inside of you. So when he's demanding it from you, he knows you can deliver it. When our brother start to sing, I said, wow, I saw him raising his eyes, open your eyes and sing. Yeah, you can do it. I said, open your eyes, small, small. I said, yes. All of have something that somebody doesn't have. You might despise its small beginnings, but it's very, very huge. Because you can't imagine that these small, small peaches, peaches, talk, in the apple, can be a big tree. Can you even imagine that? It's unimaginable. But this small seed can go to the ground, you cover it, 3 days, 4 weeks, 1 week. See, the ground is very hard. This small seed will push the soil. Who has been to a farm before? It will push, even if there is a stone there, it will bypass it some ways. You can't even understand it. That's God's doing. So the little beginning that you have seen in you, don't despise it. God knows how. Don't ask your business. Now God's business be that. The only thing you have to do is take the first step. If now I take the first step and put this seed of pay in the ground, water it. Water it. Whatever goes under the ground, I don't care. All that I care is I want to see the bone standing there with my pay. Simple. Why don't you start putting your dreams on paper, youth? Some of you have perfect dreams, plans. But if you have a plan, you don't write it down, you call it a dormant plan. It's nits. It doesn't matter. You dream up something nice. When you wake up, take a pen and paper, write it down. He told the prophet, say, write the vision down. Even though it might tell you, write it down. By this day, we take our mobile phone and we press on it, put the phone. And the phone will come out, everything is gone. Sure. Jesus said, what is written is. He didn't say what is typed is typed. Start writing those. When you see me next time and I don't see you right now, sack you. Who's going to? When next time I come and I'm standing here and I don't see you writing something. Amen.
Amen.
But whatever that you write down, it becomes part of you. Amen.
Amen.
Today is Lord's Supper. So why am I bringing this? You might ask yourself, why is it that I can't do what I dreamt of? Why is it that I can't do this, but somebody can do this? Sometimes you think you wanted to do one thing, but somebody did. I thought about doing this, you know. What you thought about? Why didn't you do it? Why didn't you do it? But you waited. We are procrastinating every day and every night. The things that God has given to you, they didn't come by accident. The dream that you had some time ago, God could have given the dream to somebody else, but he gave it to you. But why is it that the blanket men's outside, they make watches, they make video camera, they make the phones, but we can do nothing? Why? Did we have 2 heads? Or 10 fingers on one hand? No. Why? The moment they have something, they put it down, and they start working on it. I came to wake somebody up that today, today being the Lord's Supper day, if you have forgotten anything else, the moment you sat down to eat with the person who gave it to you, tell him again, Lord, today that I'm having the chance to eat with you, can you please remind me what you blessed in ceremony when I was 1 year born? And that's it. When we are getting some kind of 25 to 30 years, whenever you find a nice girl, go to have good conversation, you take her to restaurants. But during the eating, you can look at her face and talk. Those of you who have done that before, you know what I'm talking about. During the dinner time, there's no time for anger. Even with our spouse at home, when heat boils up so much, you don't settle the matters in the house. Take her outside. Well, outside, when I'm crazy, I can't beat my wife in the door. I can never come on. Nobody can do that. So the time of the dinner, talk. The way he talked to the king. He made him. He knows what kind of seed he put inside him. It's a high time we wake up and do something. I see some nice girls, they put nice hair on. I'm not talking about your hair. But all these nice hair, they are fiber that somebody designed. I used to run an African shop in Tilbury. 1999, 2000, 2007. I went to go to take them.
They take this rubber, they put in the machine, and say, ah, is that how they made this hair? And you put up, moving to, ah! Wow, so it's very simple. You put this one canicolor in hot water, it twists. Ah, oh! And somebody is dropping money from it. And you are buying them.
Ah, but if you know where it comes from, you don't buy them again. Oh, not so expensive as now. But let me challenge you today. Look inside of you. There's something there. If you look inside of this pear, there's something there. That something is more valuable than the fruit you see today. The small voice you have is powerful. The moves you make when you dance is powerful. Can you imagine PwC Antwerp, Turnout? You are on the public media, singing and dancing, it even attracts people. One of my students in Breda, he wants to come to this place, PI, in our place. I said, no, Turnout is Dick Tabai. He saw my preaching on my Facebook and my YouTube channel. He see how the vibrance and the jumping is there, and he wants, I said, I will give this address to her to come here. You see, what you do can challenge somebody to come to the Lord.
Glory.
Amen.
But when we are singing that, amen. There is something inside of you. Let me use my own life as an illustration here for you. I was in prison in UK 2007. I came out 2010. When I came, my shop, I had a big shop with 7 employees. Everything gone. My house sold, my cars are gone, I had nothing. I said, God, I pray to you in prison that I don't want to go to fabric. Not that people who are wrecking the fabric, I am more than them. Mm-hmm. But I have a level, I don't want my level to drop, God. Mm-hmm. I told God like that, eh? This it's like conversation. I put a chair there, I sat here, I said, God, now me and you. And after praying this prayer, the guy I was living with, I was sleeping in somebody's living room. So Andy, you, whenever I have Legland's letter you read to me, the way you explain to me is different from even the guy who called himself. I understand you much better. And when you used to teach deadlines, you were better. Why don't you make teaching your work? Teaching. You see, when you are school, they ask you the job you want to do.
Yeah.
Everybody can say, I'll be a doctor. I'll be a pilot.
Yeah.
Engineer, this and that. When I go to Nashville, I'll think about being a teacher.
Yeah.
When the guy told me, I said, yes, I know. Right from the preacher school, I used to teach my own classmates. If it's great, so I used to do the same thing. So I felt the guy has hit me at the right point. I said, wow, are you sure I can do it? I said, yeah, why not? I said, what should I teach? I went back to God in prayer. After praying again, God directed me back to the same guy. He said, in this area, we have never seen a black man who owns a driving school. Why don't you make that one your job? I said, oh, that's my leg. I can't do it. Ah, it's good that people have faith in you. If somebody sees something good in you, he compliments you, take it. Through the words he gave me, I went to school. 14 months later, I owned my own driving school.
Yeah.
I don't work for no one. Why? He saw the teaching seed inside of me. Somebody here has a sinking seed inside. Somebody has a poem seed inside. So come out, put things on paper. The Bible says, commit your ways unto the Lord, he will direct your steps.
Yeah.
Whenever you wrote those things on paper, bring it back to you and say, God, this is what I put on paper. Direct my plans for me, God will do it.
Amen.
Let me show you why we are not able to do what God says we should do. For you to discover your potential, you must always be connected to your source. Let me ask this question. When God wanted to create fish, who did he speak to?
The
sea. When he wanted to create the fruits and the herbs and the grapes, who did he speak to?
The soil.
The earth. When he wanted to get stars, who did he speak to? The firmaments.
The
skies. So anytime God wants something, he speaks to the environment. Let the sea bring forth fish. Let the earth bring forth that. Let this bring forth that he always speaks to the environment. The question is, when God wanted to create you, who did he speak to? Himself. Come for yourself. Hear the hidden secret here. When we take fish out of water and put it there, what will you do? Because you disconnected from the source. When I take a flower or a plant from the ground, put it here, what will happen?
Fade,
and it will die. I have disconnected from the source. Imagine the same with me and you. If we disconnect ourselves from the Lord, we will do what? Die. All the potentials in the sea will. So I challenge you today, if you want to grow and bear fruit, not the fruit we chop, but the fruit that God has given to you, connect yourself to the source.
Amen.
Today, the source has set the table here. He said, you want the seed I have given inside of you to germinate? Maybe you were angry, you left home, you have not eaten. Now connect yourself to me at the dining table. And let me revive you. Let me reconnect you. Let me remold you. Let me make you a new. Somebody can open his Bible with me to Matthew, please. Matthew 25. Because of time. Matthew 25. Who is there? Verse 14. I want the paper Bible.
Matthew chapter 25, verse 14.
Mm-hmm.
Again, it will be like a man going on a journey who called his servant and entrusted his property to them.
Mm-hmm.
15. To one, he gave 5 talents of money.
Mm-hmm.
To another, 2 talents, and to another, 1 talent, each according to his ability.
Mm-hmm.
Then he went on his journey. The man who had received the 5 talents went at once and put his money to work, and gave 5 more. So also the one with the 2 talents gave 2 more. But the man who had received 1 talent went up, dug a hole in the ground, and hid his master's money. After a long time, the master of those servants returned and settled accounts with them. The man who had received the 5 talents brought the other 5. Master, he said, you entrusted me with 5 talents. See, I have gained 5 more. His master replied, well done, good and faithful servant. You have been faithful with few things. I will put you in charge of many things. Come and share your master's happiness. 22. The man with the 2 talents also came. Master, he said, you entrusted me with 2 talents. See, I have gained 2 more. His master replied, well done, good and faithful servant. You have been faithful with these few things. I will put you in charge of many things. Come and share your master's happiness. Then the man who had received the 1 talent came. Master, he said, I knew that you are a hard man, harvesting where you have not sown, and gathering where you have not scattered seed. So I was afraid and went out and hid your talent in the ground. See, here is what belongs to you. His master replied, You wicked lazy servant. So you knew that I harvest where I have not sown, and gather where I have not scattered seed. Well then, you should have put my money on deposit with the bankers, so that when I return, I would have received it back with interest. Take the 28. Take the talent from him and give it to the one who has the 10 talents. For everyone who has will be given more, and he will have an abundance.
Yes.
Whosoever does not have, even what he has will be taken from him.
Please, thank you. You know this story. Even the one that you think you don't have, that little one will be taken. It's very painful. He gave all of us talent. Some are bigger, some are smaller. Some of you can dance, some can jump, some can sing, some can shout. It is something. He said, invest them. The man who got 5, invested the 5. By the time the master came back, he had double. The one who got 2 or 3 did the same thing. My question is, what have you received? If you receive only one, invest it. Because if you don't do so, he will come and then he will take the little that you have and give it. I wish this man will not sing and I'm going to collect his voice and give it to me. I would like it too. I like your voice. Do something with what you have. They are called your potentials. If you can do something that you have not done it yet, it is your potential. If you have a dream that you need to make it accomplished, you have to do something about it before time flies. Don't disconnect yourself from the source. He just said something in John chapter 15, verse 4, he says, he said, I am the vine. If you connect yourself to me, you bear fruit. I never see somebody going to the farm and cut a branch of pear and brought it in the room for the branch alone to bear apple fruit. It will never happen. It must always be attached to the tree. And as long as we are producing it or not, ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters, you are attached to the Lord, you bear fruit.
Amen.
But the seed cannot bear fruit unless the farmer plants it. President was asking, how many times have you read your Bible this week? Somebody say one time, somebody say three times, and shamefully enough, somebody say I've not read it even the whole week. It's good to be honest, but this kind of honesty, better don't be. Yeah, read your Bible. Let me ask, how many times a day do you eat? You are on diet. You don't want to grow fat. But how many times a day do you eat? Four times, you see. Four times a day, you chop. How many times a day do you read your Bible?
Zero.
Zero. You see, we should balance it. You cannot bear fruit if you detach yourself from the source. Shh, I'm here. A fish can never survive when you detach it from the water. The plant can never survive when you take it out from the soil. It can't. Likewise, the seed can never bear fruit if you detach it from the soil. And your source is the word of God. Your source is the Holy Spirit. Your source is God Himself. If you minus any one of these, you never bear fruit. How can you achieve your potentials if you go away with all these? The Bible says in Corinthians, 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 14, chapter 2, verse 4. Say, eye has not seen, ear have not heard, neither has entered into the heart of man what God has for them that love him. Nobody knows what you have. Accept yourself. But if you love the Lord, you stay connected to Him, He will make sure whatever that He has for you will be accomplished.
Amen.
I'm going to bring my message very close to an end. But I'm challenging each one of you to pray inside of you and say, God, direct me where my dreams are, where my potentials are. Otherwise, you are going to rob your entire generation with what you're supposed to have had. Let me ask my last question. Who is man's greatest enemy?
Himself.
And then what was your name? Who is man's greatest enemy? Brother? Any answer is correct. Say something.
What is the question?
The question is, who or what is man's greatest enemy? No problem. Okay. We is a pretty fiant on the lens. Fiant.
Yeah.
Satan. Thank you, well. My name is Satan. It's Iman Angus. We is it? No. Are you yourself your own enemy? Why don't you kill yourself then? It's your turn, name.
Fear.
Fear, no. It's ignorance. You didn't know this?
Yeah.
Now you know. It's ignorance. Ignorance is your worst enemy. It's in the Bible. Should I show you? Hosea 4 says, let's go there. Hosea chapter 4, verse 6. Old Testament. Let me close. It's now 1 o'clock.
Hosea chapter.
Hosea 4, 6. Yeah, please go ahead.
Hosea chapter 4,
verses. Mm-hmm. My people are destroyed from lack of knowledge.
Please take it through one by one. One by one.
My people are destroyed.
What is destroying the people?
Lack of knowledge. Mm-hmm. Because you have rejected knowledge, mm-hmm. I also reject you as my priest.
Hold on. You are talking.
We're talking about the Bible.
It's
open to Isaiah.
If he doesn't want to open, is that your problem?
No, I wanted to read it. I don't have my Bible with me.
Why are you coming to fire without your campus, Mr. Farmer?
Oh, I was late.
My people are destroyed for what?
Lack of knowledge.
He didn't say my people are destroyed because of Satan. He didn't say my people are destroyed because their fathers and mothers beat them. He didn't say my people are destroyed because they don't pay their tithes. They are destroyed because of what? Okay. And go ahead. What does he say?
Because you have ignored the law of your God. Mm-hmm. I will also ignore your children.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. Hold it there. The NKJV, the New King James said, my people are destroyed. You can say that. Thank you. My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. And because you have rejected knowledge, you can never reject what is not there. Anything you reject, it means it was there before you rejected it. So if I say, Akosia, take the hanky, say, no, I don't want the hanky. It was there, but you rejected it. Your potentials are there, but you rejected them. Your sweet voice is there, but you rejected it. You can develop it into a CD. It will hit the number one on the radio. People will be chasing you for your CD alone. Mm-hmm. You can do better. And he said, because you have rejected knowledge, I will also reject
you.
Who is speaking here?
God.
We thought God has not rejected. And he rejects. Eh? Okay. If he is rejecting only you, it's not a problem. But look at what's following here. I will also reject you from being my priest. Because you have forgotten the law of your God, I will also forget about your children. As if when you are, how old are you? Who is the youngest here? Yeah. Who am I? 13. Who is the oldest here? Maybe me. So if God is rejecting only you, so the problem is your children. So imagine, you don't know anything, and you are teaching your children what you know. They will be like you. That's how it is. So knowledge is power. The truth of knowledge is power. Always seek for knowledge. The word of God. Connect yourself to it, and that one will bring you how to go about with your potentials. Otherwise, we are going to go away from this surface of the earth. We leave nothing to our children. My father died, he's gone. Somebody's father died, he left him an articulated tract and tall buildings and money. But what are we leaving for our children? What you plan today, your children and great-grandchildren will come and benefit from it. Amen.
Amen.
And it can start from here. This pear seed, it came from another tree before today is here. The same way applies to you. What God has given you, when you put it in good use, your great great grandchildren will come and thank you for it.
Amen.
The main question is, don't detach yourself from the source.
Amen. Amen.
When I take this one from the ground, like I said, it will die. The man is saying, your spirit must connect to Christ. Stay closer to him. Get knowledge from his word. And sometimes let your phone rest. Open your Bibles. If you eat three times a day, and you come to church once a week, you pray once a week. You read the Bible once a week. You become like the man God is talking about in Hosea chapter 4, verse 6. You will perish and God will make me churchable. God will get you. Amen.
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 So your potential is what you can become. but you have not become yet. Your potential is a goal you can reach, but you have not reached there yet. I pray that the Lord today will reach somebody.
Amen.
In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Let's move on. Feet. We are going to have a short prayer, and from there we move on to the Lord's Supper.